Hi everyone, it's Vicky here and welcome back. This week I'm going to have Christmas in August, and that's because the new Fall and Christmas Foil Collection by Spellbinders has just been released. The products are amazing and I will be sharing 3 videos throughout the week where you can see them in action. For today I'm going to play with these 2 background foil plates. It's the sweater foil plate and the snowflakes one. I absolutely love them. You will see that they give gorgeous results, and all you have to do is to just add a sentiment at the center or add your focal point. So I'm going to start with the first one, and I'm working on a panel. This is 4.25 by 5.5, so it's going to cover up completely my card front. And I'm starting by adding a little bit of distress oxide ink in Vintage Photo all around the edges. I just want to give that vintage look on this card. I'm going super traditional on this card with greens, reds and golds. So here I'm using the plate, which is called Christmas Sweater Background from the new collection, and I'm going to use red foil to do that. So I'm going red on red for a very subtle look, but at the same time it's going to create a gorgeous background. Now I'm going to secure everything with my washi tape. While my platform is still getting warm, I am going to create the second background. This time I'm using the snowflake sparkle background with this wonderful foil. This time I used a navy blue cardstock, again 4.25 by 5.5, and I'm using this really sparkly foil. You need to wait for that light to stop blinking, then you know that your plate is warm, and I'm going to run it through my die cutting machine. I always like to do that slowly, and I do that a couple of times, so this way I know that I will end up with a good impression of the foiling. Now, after doing that for both my backgrounds, here are the wonderful results. I absolutely love both of them. I think they make the perfect Christmas cards. So here is the one with red on red, and this is the one with a sparkly silver foil on top of the navy blue. Now, Yannas Makula has came up with her own line of Christmas foiling plates, and they are all just amazing. For today, I'm going to use her sentiments, and you can see that they come with sentiments along with dies that cut them out, and I will feature this set on another video this week. And I'm going to combine it with this poinsettia set where you get the plates for different sizes as well as the dies to cut them out. I'm going to use gold foil and this off-white cardstock to cut out my poinsettias. I'm going to also use the tiny little leaves with green cardstock and green foiling, so green on green for this one. And after foiling and using the dies, the matching dies, to cut out all the shapes, here are all ready to go. Now I ended up using the Merry Christmas sentiment. I also used a circle die and the same red cardstock to cut out a circle so that I can pop it on top of my card and have a raised area. I am also going to add some distress oxide ink all around the edges to match the outside panel. And I will add a touch of Vintage Photo on my poinsettia flowers, just because I don't want them to be so bright. I'm going for a vintage look and feel. I'm going to ink up the edges of the green leaves as well. And I'm using a cloth over all those images because some of the ink stays on top of the foiled areas. So I'm just making sure that everything is nice and clean. And now I can put together my card. I'm sticking this circle at the center, and then I'm going to put together my flower. Now I'm using my fingers very lightly to lift the petals, and then I can stick one flower on top of the other, a slightly offset so that it looks fuller. If you want, you can use foam tape in between, but this is going to make it super raised, and it's not going to fit inside an envelope for sure. I am also going to stick that on top of my center, and then I can tuck underneath the green leaves. Well, as far as I know, they are all considered leaves when it comes to poinsettias, but I like to call them flowers and leaves, so you know exactly which parts I am describing. So you see that at the center of these backgrounds, you can stick any focal point, Christmas focal point that you like. It can be an ornament, for example. On the sentiment, again, I'm going to do a little bit of inking on the edges just to bring everything together. I did trim about a quarter of an inch all around, so you will see when I stick it on top of my card base, it's going to be slightly smaller, so I ended up having a lovely border. I think this is a gorgeous Christmas card in traditional colors, and here you can see some close-up photos. And as I always say, and I am going to say it again, it's really difficult to catch all that shine in photos, but in real life it looks stunning. So let's move on to the second background, where I did that lovely silver foiling on top of my navy blue card base. And now I'm using a circle die. I'm placing it at the center, secure it with my washi tape, run it through my die cutting machine, and this way I ended up having a little window. Now you can easily turn this background into a shaker card, however I'm just going for a window card for today. Now I have a white panel that's 4.25 by 5.5, and I have temporarily placed that window panel on top so that I can decide where I want all those little elements to go. The sentiments I'm going to use are again from the Yannis Makula Christmas sentiments. I combined from with another phrase that says our home to yours. Now these two sentiments lock together, as you can see here in the photo, which means that you know that they are in between them perfectly aligned. Of course, I'm using some washi tape to secure them down. And now below the sentiment, I'm going to use some plates from the Glimmer White Village. Now this is another set by Yannis Makula, and it comes along with a couple of villages that you can nest if you want one on top of the other, or just use one of them. And there is a third plate in the set that gives you snow. Now I'm just playing and testing out all those plates, trying to decide which one I'm going to use. And for foiling on this card, I went with silver. So now I decided which one I'm going to use. I'm going to place it where this should go, secure it down with my washi tape, and then I'm going to place it on the platform. I'm going to wait for those plates to be nice and warm, run them through my die cutting machine, and here is the finished result. Now I have a silver foiled village, a lovely scene, as well as my sentiment. If you find that you end up having some overfoiling, just use a sand eraser. It works like magic. I am using foam tape at the back of my window panel and stick it on top, and you can call this card done. Now when I saw that, I was absolutely happy with it, but I decided to take it a step further just because I love adding new details. So if you want it clean and simple, leave it as it is, but I'm going to show you three more steps that you can do. The first thing I did was add a dot of glue on some of the snowflakes at the center, and then I'm going to stick on top white gems. I'm not going to do it on all the snowflakes, just few of them. Now the second thing that I did was to add some inking on my sky. Of course, this is a step that you can do before putting the whole thing together, and then it's easier. However, I did manage to do it with my blending brush, and it worked just fine. And finally, I'm going to use some of the plates from the Christmas organic foliage, and I'm going to embellish my window a little bit. This is a lovely set, and I am going to feature it on the video that's coming up on Friday, so check that out, you will see more of the set in that video. Here are some close-up photos on my blue and silver card. I'm absolutely in love with this card, I think it's so elegant and pretty. And I cannot recommend these foiling plates enough. I think that they make stunning cards. So here are both my projects for today. Don't forget, just like always, you will find links to everything I used linked down below in the description area, as well as on my blog. I hope that you had fun today, that you got inspired. Thank you all so much for joining me today, and I'll see you all next time.